Now let's consider one last very interesting case, and that is a magnetic field toroid. A toroid, is typically made up of a donut-shaped ring of magnetic material, and it usually has a value of mu r greater than 1. And this material is wrapped like this with a wire. You just take that wire and you just wrap it around that donut. So you can see this wire is in front, then back, then front, then back, and so on. And you run a current through it. And we want to know how much magnetic field can be generated in this toroid. So what I'm going to do is put my Gaussian surface right around the center of this donut, like you can see here. And let's figure out how much magnetic field we have. Well, our Gaussian contour is still exactly the same as the one we just did, so we know that our left-hand side integral is going to give us 2 pi r h phi. Now we need to figure out how much current is enclosed in this toroid. Let's look at it again just from the top. Here's my donut, and there's my Gaussian contour. That's where I'm going to find my magnetic field. Now the only current that's going to be enclosed in that Gaussian contour is the part of the current where this wire goes in, carrying the current in, so it's going into the board, and then it comes back out, but it comes back out over here, and then it goes in there, and out here, and in there, and out here, in, out, and so on. So depending on how many turns, n, I have, I'm able to figure out how much current I actually have enclosed. The only parts that I need to consider are these parts right here that are going in, because the other parts outside, such as these, are not enclosed in my Gaussian surface. So this is equal to n times the current that is flowing in the wire. So my magnetic field in this toroid is ni over 2 pi r. Now, where does the fact that the magnetic permeability is greater than 1 play in here? Remember that B is equal to mu H. So if I wanted to find my magnetic flux density, it would be mu naught times mu r times ni over 2 pi r, and it would be in the phi direction as shown here. So this is a very interesting case of a toroid. Toroids are used for many things. One of the things that a toroid can be used for is picking up and measuring a magnetic field. So if you have a magnetic field that is generated like this, you can actually produce a current that can be read in this particular coil. So you can go backwards or forwards. You can either have a current generate a magnetic field as we just calculated, or if we wanted to use this toroid as a pickup for the magnetic field instead, we could have the magnetic field produce a current in this wire, and it goes back and forth, the calculations are identical. So if we wanted to know how much current would be generated from that magnetic field, we would simply solve for current instead of solving for H. So the current would be 2 pi r h phi divided by n.